Now, I was sent this box of IMs and it looked pretty interesting, so let's check it out. Alright, as a disclaimer, this was sent out to me for review, but this won't affect my review in any way, shape, or form. Everything you're gonna hear here is my own personal opinion of them. Also, another disclaimer, this is not an audiophile review. I will be touching on audiophile topics in regards to what it can do, but the main focus of this review is how well this will do in gaming. That being said, let's get started on the review.
Now, the IEMs I have on hand are the Opera Factory OS1 Pros by Wizard, which comes in a pretty graffiti-styled box, which continues to the inside, where we get a nice presentation where we'll be getting the IEMs and the cable, 3 sets of ear tip sizes, a warranty card, and a manual. Out of the box, the OS1 Pros are pre-attached to the cable, which is nicely braided, though this is pretty standard at this price range. It uses the ear hook style to hook around your ears, and this model uses the memory hooks, which are pre-formed, allowing them to bounce back into shape when stretched out. Along the right side cable, there's also an inline microphone with a single button for pause play as well as ending calls.
For those wondering, this is how the microphone sounds. It's passable. It's an inline microphone.
Moving further down the cable, we have a splitter, which is this interesting shape, and it's decently sturdy enough. And at the very end of the cable is a 3.5mm jack, which is angled at 90 degrees. Moving on to the IEMs, they are firmly connected to the cable and use a standard 2-pin connection. The IEMs themselves are mostly made of plastic aside from the little brass bit here, and have Opera Factory Junior printed on them. The shell is translucent with a bunch of golden sparkles all around it, with left and right indicators on the back. The nozzles are also made of plastic, but should be sturdy as they're part of the body itself. And in the nozzles themselves, you'll find metal grills which will help keep things from getting into the IEMs. The silicone ear tips are pretty standard, so nothing to write home about. Now here's how the OS1 Pros look like on my head, and honestly, I did feel they were kind of on the larger side of things, so they didn't sit super flush with the side of my head, but at least they didn't stick out like crazy. Despite the size, after several hours of usage, they were actually still pretty comfortable, and this might be because they're very light. Do remember that your mileage will vary depending on the size of your ears. Mine's are big.
Now the OS1 Pros are marketed to be very good for rock and pop, but I've also personally found them to be very good for rap and any sort of electronic kind of music, and this is because it has a very warm sound signature with a great emphasis on bass. The bass on these guys is very strong, it's very punchy, and very boomy. It definitely makes its presence known, but sometimes this strong bass presence will bleed a little bit into the mids. Now the mids themselves are very clear and sound really good, especially for voices. The highs are just okay. They're not the most amazing sounding highs in the world, but they give enough detail and clarity, and they're okay. Now the soundstage on these guys is just okay. It's small, which is to be expected of an IEM, but it still gives you a decent amount of space to work with around you as well as above you in terms of like spatial awareness. That being said, when it comes to imaging utilizing that space we're given, it's actually pretty decent. It's not pinpoint accurate, but I still get a pretty good general sense of where things are and should be around me and above me. The whole above me thing is very useful, especially if you're playing games, which we're gonna get into right now.
With the soundstage the way it was on the OS1 Pros, I actually didn't have any trouble tracking anything in game. And this is because the sound signature greatly emphasizes the sounds of major sound effects of the games, essentially helping me find the sounds that I want to hear when I'm trying to track, such as the sounds of footsteps and gunfire. The sound also becomes very engaging, making action games very exciting. I should note that while tracking is good, the sounds of explosions can sometimes be a bit overwhelming if there's a lot of back-to-back explosions, which can cover up the sounds of where people are. The OS1 Pros also sound good outside of action games, where it emphasizes the sound of the environment, which is engaging in its own right.
Now, as for my final thoughts of these IEMs, if you're a basshead looking for a very bassy IEM that'll make your games very engaging and exciting, particularly action games, then these are definitely the ones for you. Now, if you're more of a balanced sound kind of person and you want more of a neutral sound signature, these are definitely not going to be for you, unless maybe you want that one really strong bassy set for that time when you do want that boom. Anyway guys, if you do want these guys, they do currently cost $25.99, so like $26 essentially on Amazon, which I'll leave a link to in the description if you do want to buy it, and it is an affiliate link, so if you buy off of that link, I'll get a slight kickback, which will help me run this channel. That being said, that's pretty much all I got for today, so if you like the video, do leave me a like, subscribe if you love the content, and I am streaming on Twitch, which I'll leave also like the details in the description, and I guess I'll see you guys next time.